Do you want the symbols in your PI Coresight display to change color depending on your data conditions? In this video, I will show you how to do this with multi-state functionality. We use this display to monitor one of our chemical reactors, and something that's really important for that reactor is to make sure that the temperature doesn't go above certain limits. Now, it would be really nice if I went to look at this display that I could instantly know we were having a problem, or if we were close to having a problem, if the color would change depending on how close we were to having a temperature excursion. Let me show you how we can set that up. What I want to do first is I want to make sure that I am in design mode by hitting Modify Display. And I can tell I'm in design mode because of this orange box that appears around my display. So I want to configure this gauge for multi-state. So what I want to do is right-click and do Add Multi-State. And this is going to bring up the configuration over here on the right. You can see that the attribute that we're going to be triggering off of is going to be our reactor temperature. That makes sense because that's what the gauge is for. Now, looking down here, this is where I can specify the different states and what colors they should be. You might be wondering where some of these values come from. And the top and bottom values can be based on the maximum and minimum AF attribute limits, or if those are not specified, the zero and span pi point attributes. However, I can change any of these values to be exactly what we want for this particular gauge multi-state. In my case, I want to have only three states, so I'll use the X's and reduce this down here. Okay, so let's think about this. If the temperature is 0 all the way up to 80, that's fine. Normal operation, so I'm good with this being green. Now what I'm thinking is it'll be nice if we're getting close to the temperature excursion for this to change to an orange, and then if we're having an excursion to be red. Now I'll need to change this to 90. So now if the temperature is greater than 0 all the way up to 80, it should be green. And if it's greater than 80 all the way up to 90, it will be orange. And if it's greater than 90, it's going to be red. So now that I've got that set up exactly how we want, I'm going to click back somewhere on my display. Okay, so right now I can see that the temperature is about 20 degrees, and so it's green. Now let me scroll back in time and make sure we get the other behaviors that we just set up too. So let's shorten the time interval a little bit. Okay, now let's take a look at the last time we had a temperature excursion. So looks like, yep, right here. Okay, so in this case, our gauge would have made it very clear that there was a problem by turning red. And let's check out right before, when we were starting to get close. Perfect. It would have shown orange to let us know that we were getting close to having an issue. Okay, so this looks pretty good. Now, is the only symbol I can add a multi-state functionality to this gauge? No. I can add multi-state behavior to values, as well as shapes, images, and text. And let's actually do the multi-state behavior for a shape, because I might want something that looks more like an indicator light. So let's add a circle. Yeah, and let me add this on top of my image. Now to add the multi-state behavior, same process, we're going to right-click and do Configure Multi-State. Now, the steps will all be the same, except for at the very beginning, I'll actually need to drag and drop a data item that's going to be the attribute to associate with the different states. And that makes sense because the gauge already had an attribute for it, the temperature, but a shape doesn't have an attribute associated with it. So we'll go ahead and add one here. I want this to be for the reactor temperature. So I'm going to select this and then drag it over. Okay. And I'm going to make the same configuration as I did for the gauge. Okay, so perfect. Now it's very easy for me to tell where we are with our temperature. And scrolling back in time and forward, I'll be able to instantly know how close we are to having a problem. But it looks like we're doing just fine right now. I have this really great display for reactor 300 here, but there's a lot of other reactors that I monitor. So let me show you how I can easily swap assets and change this display to easily monitor my other reactors. We'll do that in the next video.